For several seconds, Thomas felt like the world had frozen in place. A thick silence followed the thunderous rumble of the door closing, and a veil of darkness seemed to cover the sky, as if even the sun had been frightened away by what lurked in the maze. Twilight had fallen, and the mammoth walls looked like enormous tombstones in a weed-infested cemetery for giants. Thomas leaned back against the rough rock, overcome by disbelief at what he had just done, filled with terror at what the consequences might be. Then a sharp cry from Albie up ahead snapped Thomas to attention. Minyu was moaning. Thomas pushed himself away from the wall and ran to the two gliders. Minyu had pulled himself up and was standing once again, but he looked terrible, even in the pale light still. Available, sweetie, dirty, scratched up. Albie, on the ground, looked worse, his clothes ripped, his arms covered with cuts and bruises. Thomas shuddered. Had Albie been attacked by a griever? Greeny, Minyu said, if you think that was brave common out here, listen up. You're the shuckst shuck-faced shock there ever was. You're as good as dead, just like us. Thomas felt his face heat up. He expected at least a little gratitude. I couldn't just sit there and leave you guys out here. And what good are you with us? Minyu rolled his eyes. Whatever, dude.